We'll have to see.
We'll see.
Nakat is trying out other characters today at MSM. He's made it this far with the Pichu, it looks like. Kind of taking a book out of, or a page out of Void's book in this scenario. But we'll have to see how it works out.
I like how he looks for the female Pikachu that has a little three prong on the ears.
Is that the female Pikachu? Yeah. I thought it was the heart tail, or is that
no? So when it's Pichu, it's the ears.
Okay.
When it's Pikachu, it's the heart tail.
Okay, interesting. Alrighty, here we go. Just gonna get a quick throw combo. Got a tech chase situation on that platform too. It's small enough where Pichu should be able to react to whatever option S2H pulls out.
Oh, also gonna cat is going full throttle there, and he immediately sends S2H down to the depths. Pretty tough call for him. Already losing the stock with only 23% in the cat's aim.
Yeah,
it's kind of tough running on Pichu because she's the lightest character in this game. So in theory, right, Meta Knight should have a lot of things to just get the ladder and kill Pichu early percent. But it's hard to touch around the size of someone's toe, you know.
Yeah, I think one of the harder things is that just the angles that Meta Knight's hitboxes come out.
Yeah.
It's just gonna go around Pichu just because of how short they are. And Meta Knight's much better in air-to-air than in the grounded approach options.
Exactly.
It's kind of the same character. You got the... You got the dash attack, you got dash grab, and then you have those aerials, but against a very small Pichu, it's going to be difficult to get those hitboxes out.
Yeah, Pichu has a lot of an easier time trying to challenge Meta Knight in the air, of course. That's one thing, though, when we're talking about the air-to-air battle here, that's one thing I want to see S2H take. Finally, stops himself here, sees that forward smash, Nakat holding out a little bit too long. S2H is not going to be keen to run into that. S2H is not a fan of rolling or going for dash attacks too often, and I like the fact that Nakat's trying to do that to anticipate S2H's coming, but unfortunately, S2H clipped by that force smash using the stock.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me. Okay.
I did not think that was going to kill, but you know what? That red flash is a little bit unreliable, okay. So we got to keep that in mind. It's like the red lightning. But wow, I'm liking these dare conversions, forcing no techs or just forcing S2H to react to those kinds of situations. Very different from Void, who likes to go for the up air and nair strings instead.
Yeah.
We don't see too many dares coming out from... the cat in particular, but a pivot forward smash.
Yeah.
Every Pichu knows how to do that. That's going to take out that first game.
S2H not too happy how that first encounter played out. Me and S2H, we're in a group chat together. We kind of talked about this matchup. I kind of want to see S2H start looking to camp out Pichu here. One thing that I'm noticing from the cat is he's going full throttle. He comes in with Joel. He comes in with his options. S2H is left to play on the defensive side. He should have been looking to camp him out, wait for the end lag on some moves here, and then make the approach. We'll see what game 2 brings about for S2H. Hopefully some adaptation here, but Nakat definitely taking game 1 predominantly.
I think another problem that Meta Knight has is that also while his hitboxes aren't really in the right angles, another thing is that their hitboxes are very quick. Usually against a small character like Pichu, you want kind of long-lasting stroke hitboxes to be able to try and catch them in the air, and even if your position's not completely correct, you can still catch them on like a weak hit or something like that.
Yeah.
You saw in like Super Smash Bros., for example, that Larry didn't do too well with the box, but with the Falco, who had a longer-lasting hitbox due with those fairs, those back airs, was able to catch Void more often than with the quick fairs and up airs that Fox is known for. So this is a difficult scenario for Meta Knight altogether, and also that's a difficult scenario just running into that pivot forward smash again.
This is the thing that S2H is having a tough time here. I feel like he's a little bit flustered. I want to see him kind of stand back, right? Look at his opponent there. Because at that situation, he had multiple jumps from the ledge. He didn't have to come back to the stage right away. He could have picked and chosen his time.
A little bit too high to get those drag down bear into up tilt combos, but Nakat's still going to get a little bit more damage. Again, another dare. Nakat's been doing a good job of keeping himself in a good defensive position as well, just using those quick hitboxes and the quick trick data
to
get away from S2H.
Good drag down the down smash. S2H now respecting the spacing after he saw that last time in that encounter here. And like from the dimensional cape, and Nakat will take that. Good tech from S2H, but he sends him right back up, man. He sent him around the town.
Yeah. That time, S2H was able to find a tech, but Nakat just reacted to it, find a tech chase situation instead. Still worked out for them, throwing out that forward tilt, not quite going to do it, but...
Oh wow. Great. I want to say it was the either that he held, trying to go for the up B out of shield there, and that forward smash good punish from Nakat. Looking like another possible runaway 3 stock against S2H here, and he's having a tough time.
Another great tech. He tried to use that long-lasting hitbox to catch him there, but Pichu not quite going to die to that yet, still able to find a tech chase situation, or excuse me, the tech situation.
Is that forward air? S2H using those multiple jumps just to get over that thunder.
Kind of go around here using that thunder jolt. Ooh.
Yeah, he ran out of fuel at that point. But this is what I wanted to talk about, right? We're seeing the cat go full throttle here, and S2H should be looking to just take the time to pick his apart his opponent. He has a game. He needs to formulate a game plan here, and he's just coming in raw.
Yeah, but it's just one of those scenarios that's kind of difficult. I feel like Pichu is just better at keeping characters away just with that speed. Like, it's not like Pichu is a slow character that can't catch up to other characters. Like, Pichu will be able to catch up and still come in at S2H, even if he tries to keep away. So I feel like it's just a difficult scenario all around, I feel. Fourth throw, gonna take them off. Try to read a high recovery, not quite gonna work there. But again, Bear right out of shield. Yeah. Quick option, keeps him in the air, and tries to catch him with a thunder. Quite work out there.
Good return on the S2H, gonna get in that back air. Okay. It all comes down to that ledge play he saw earlier. He was able to come back the last time, but he comes in a little too hot yet again. Double forward smash from the Cat.
Yeah.
2-0. Cat's favor over S2H. He's having a tough time. You can see it here on the player cam. He's just shaking his head. But one thing when it comes down to it is, like I say, man, he should be looking to cool himself down. We saw him come back from the ledge a little bit differently when we saw game one, where he was coming in too hot, too normal, with those normal get-ups. This time, he took his time to come back to stage, angle that side B yet again. It's his game plan that he needs to start formulating here. Yet again, still having that problem. Game three, we'll see if it's a little too late for S2H.
Yeah. I mean, S2H is one of those players I feel that it's very visible to see when he's tilted, when he's not performing at his best. And I'm sure the Cat is acknowledging that too. Sitting right next to each other, it's not like the major setups where they're across from each other. So it's going to be very easy for the Cat to try and run away with this momentum using that same game plan that I know is frustrating S2H right now.
Yeah. Okay, looking to see the spacing against the Thunder Drill here. I want to see him go for a couple of dare camps, probably just a little bit of camping here. Pichu can challenge him there, but if S2H gets a solid read, must be better than the ground game at the moment.
Yeah, but the difficult part is Pichu's damage output. Like, where do you camp in a situation like this where you're already at 124%? Just trying to make it back to the ledge so you can return to neutral. And finally, S2H is able to find something with that drag down fair into down tilt trip. Try to extend it to something. Got 50%, but still nothing else in the process.
Okay, I like it. S2H respects the fact that he had the whole stage to come back, come around here.
Yeah, how does Meta Knight find the kill? We already saw earlier that Meta Knight tried to go for the dash attack and got punished for it with a complete kill afterwards when he tried to go for the shuttle loop. Frame 5 F-tilt, gonna catch people in that boxing scenario very nicely. Take out the next stock.
Forward smash, and he reads the coming here. That's the thing S2H acknowledged now. He sees, I have the whole stage. If you're gonna come to me like that, let me get that forward smash here. Start looking anywhere, I can see the second stock. Both players at even stocks here, but the sense are climbing against S2H. Good downer there, and the Cat gets the comeback here, and he's too close to the forward smash. Gets caught in the middle of the jab.
I think there was a little bit of psychology reads there, too. He did the tech roll in, just like thinking to himself, okay, I gotta get away from this F smash as quickly as possible. But Nakat said, nope, I'm one step ahead of you. I'm gonna get that F smash. I'm gonna take out the next stock. And I'm already gonna combo you into another big percent combo without skull bashing into that forward smash, though. S2H finally bringing the Cat to a last stock situation here in game three.
S2H with a sigh of relief. Okay, look at trying to come in here with that forward air. Good spacing here. Walks a little bit away from the Cat. He's finally catching on.
Okay, this time trying to play a little bit more patient. Now that he has an even stock scenario, it's a little bit better for him to try and bring this around. Yeah, he doesn't try to force the approach. This time he's just trying to stay back.
Okay, I like it. This is coming onto the wire here because this is kind of like a long boxing match. He wants to probably look to tire the Cat out a little bit here and force him to start going for options where S2H has been facing. Okay, use that shuttle loop. Use the visual kick to come around.
Good. Okay, another great tech. Yeah, DI outward away from Pichu just to be able to get a tech.
Dash attack it again. And he missed the first.